Morning, ladies and gents. Just coming on to do a couple of projects, but first of all, I just want to answer a question that I received, and it was about the delicate detailed dies. As you can see, mine's well loved. sorry, the so detailed dies. Okay, and this is a set comprising of three dies, and they're absolutely gorgeous. So there's one, there's your second one, and this is the third one. Now this is what the question was about, so I'm just gonna very quickly answer that question. The lady who messaged me said she only had a small die cutting machine, and would these dies go through? So I thought, well, rather than try and explain, I'll come on and prove it. So there's my die on my cutting plate, and that card is embossed as well. So sorry about the squeak, and I'm sorry if I'm shaking, but I am. So I have the small sapphire. Okay, you can see there it's cut, and I'll just try and release it. Usually helps when you have your pokey tool. Now this card was embossed as well with one of our embossing folders. So in answer to your question, yes, it does. Okay, and to be honest with you, for the next two tutorials I'm coming up with, I have used my small die cutting machine to cut my dies with, because I just wanted to make sure in my own head before I come on telling you that yes, it does. Now, I don't know about the other small die cutting machines, but the sapphire definitely does. I'll clean that out when we're finished. So I hope that answers your question. And now I'm gonna get on and I'm gonna show you how to construct this card. Now, some of you who know me know that I have made these cards on a number of occasions, only have used lace, but I thought today I would use the delicate detailed dies. So my card base is 5.5 by 12 inches, and I scored 4 inches and 8 inches. Okay, so that gave me 3 panels of 4 inches. Then what I done was put that on my trimmer on a diagonal, and I cut, and then I done exactly the same for that side. So there's our wrap over card. And then for my DSP, this is the Fallen in Love DSP. I done exactly the same. I cut 2 panels, 4 by 5 inches, and I cut them on a diagonal, and they're gonna go on there. So where's my glue? Because I'm not gonna faff about trying to fix glues this morning. So I've brought one that I know is open and I know is working. And we've still got gale force winds. And I think I've got half of the beach on my back lawn. So I'm just gonna put a little bit. Corners are down. Just move that out of the way. And I've cut it so that you just get a little border around the edges. And I know a few of you have known me for some time. I'm not showing you anything new, but it seemed to work well. So I don't want to put that much glue on, she says as it comes back out. So I've just left a nice little border all the way around. And if you're noticing, yes, I know I need to change my trim blade. Okay, so now on the bottom of these two, do I want to do that first? No, I won't. I will put these on first. All I've done is I ran these through the die cutting machine, the small one. And just die cutted them out, and I'm just gonna stick them to the front of my diagonal lines. So I'm gonna do this. I'm not telling you to do it by any means, any stretch of the imagination. It just works for me. You do whatever works for you. I just know that this works for me. Especially with fine, sorry for knocking the tripod. Especially with fine detailed dies, it works. And I want this up because I don't want it. I'm just going to quickly do the same to the other side as well before it dries. Okay. And again, I'm just going to stick it. I've also stuck some turn tape onto the back. Just try and peel this off. And I'm just going to fold that edge over because you're not going to see it. Nobody will even know it's there. It'll be hidden. And again with this side. going to tuck over like that. Okay. So I'll get rid of that. I should have brought my other tape in. Don't worry, I'll get one at the door. So that's the beginnings of our wraparound card, just opening this tape. As I forgot to bring the roll in that I was using. Oh, get off. And all I'm going to do is seal the bottom with a strip. Right along the bottom. Scary now on the back of my hand. Oh dear. Can you all hear that wind outside, the gale force wind? I've got the fire lit, I've got the heating on, and this house is freezing. I suppose that's what you get for living by the sea, huh? So we're just gonna fold this over. Now I'm also gonna just put a strip halfway up because I don't want it coming undone on us. So I'm just gonna go halfway up here. Now you don't want to go the full way up because you only want it up as far as it's going to cross over, because if you go too far up then you're going to stick the whole thing down. So I'll just remove that as well. Okay, so that's going to come over and it's going to stick down there. So there's the base of our card virtually done. So I'll just put that to one side for a minute. Bring in my insert. And this is the stylish. Stylish something dies. Stylish stems, that's the one. And I'm just going to have that sticking over the top, just in the center there. Oh dear, I shouldn't do these early morning videos when I've not got enough coffee in me. So I just want that stuck really central. Okay, and this is going to be our insert, and I am going to stamp on this to the bride and groom. And this is from the Falling For You stamp set. Okay, and it's this one for the bride and groom. So I will just ink this up. And I'm not worried about using me mat, because it's a red rubber stamp. just keep it there for 5 seconds to let the ink transfer. Okay, and then we're just going to stick that onto our insert. Okay, and I forgot to put my ribbon on. I'm just going to add the 1/4 inch Betty Vanilla satin ribbon to my edges there. Okay. Just see. Cut it right. Yeah. You know, this red line tape, it's brilliant, but it's a pain because if it doesn't stick to you with the static, you can't get it undone. So I'm just going to put that on the edge of our card. Too long. Scissors. Snip that up the side. Snip that little tiny bit off the top. Yeah. Same again on the other side. Now this is double-sided satin ribbon. It's shiny on both sides. And I'm going to do this one right from the bottom right up to the top. And then we can just cut that overhang off. Rubbish. I'm working around wires and all kinds because I've got this cam on charge as well, so I've got the wires sticking down in front of me and okay, so that slips in there, and I've got the embellishments that match up with this suite, and I'm going to put one there, and some pearls just on either side. I can find my pearls, I did have them when I come in. card I've got for you is really quick, really simple, and really easy. So I'm going to stick that on with the glue dot. Three, and then we'll do three the other side, and that's our case card finished. One. You can spend more time over yours. It was just that I needed to answer that question before I started on the cards. Okay, so there's card number one. And now on to card number two, and it's using the same die cuts out of the same so detailed, and it's also using the same DSP, and I've also paired it up with, I think this is either Sahara Sand or Crumb Cake, and Very Vanilla. So I'm just going to stick that on to my layer, and all I've done is A4 card cut across the center and scored in half. And you all know I come down in a quarter of an inch increments. Okay, that looks good. And this time what I'm going to do is I'm going to put our wrap around that layer before I actually attach it onto the card. So I'm going to do my stamping. And this stamp is out of the Celebration stamp set, and it's Any Occasion, and this is one that you can earn free, and you can see there it's got 20 stamps in it. Okay, so it's brilliant. As it suggests, you can use it for any occasion. And I'm just going to come back in with the Sahara Sand ink pad. Ink up my stamp. And we're just going to stamp, if I can see, try and get it as central as I can. Mr. and Mrs. Not as good as I would like it, but I'm looking over it, if you understand. And what I've done is I've just put some red line tape down either side. See, static. Just Mr. and Mrs. And we're just going to wrap that around our card, make sure it's straight, popping in with me. I'll attach this face and then I'll attach my ribbon. Squash down. There's my bow that I didn't do on camera. I know I'm a spoil sport, not giving you all the satisfaction of laughing at me trying to fold a bow on camera. Just stuck a couple of glue dots on the back. We're just going to stick that down the bottom, just there. Bring in some pearls. These little pearls here are joined. They're the only ones in the pack. All these are all separate, but these ones are all joined. So I'm just going to cut in threes. There again, that flower. There we go. So there's our two cards. I hope you give them a go. I hope I answered that question okay about the delicate detail dies. So yes, you can run them through the sapphire. I don't know, and I couldn't say about any of the other small die cutting machines, but I hope that helped. So take care for now, and I'll speak to you all soon. Bye.